Well, Big Jay Mcneely is just a cool cat, you know. He born and raised in Watts. And I started off playing jazz with Sonny Chris and Hampton Halls and Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie came to Los Angeles. I was quite a jazz enthusiast. But I studied, after I got out of school, I went and studied from a teacher named Joseph Caroline, played first chair at RKO Studio. And I went very legit, studied solfege, ear training, and learned how to play with non-pressure armature, with big sound. And one day a friend of mine said, "Do you want to record?" And I said, "Yeah." And so I was in Watts and I went to our record store and the guy gave me a CD by Glenn Miller with the drum going ch-ch-ch-ch. And I wrote Deacon Hop and that was my first hit in 1949. Totally different from playing jazz. It was screaming and hollering, playing one note many different ways to create excitement. I liked Charlie Parker. And he was my man, Charlie Parker. Then Sonny Stitt. All the guys, Coltrane, Lester Young, Don Byers, Ben Webster, Coleman Alden, all the guys are great musicians. You have to study, you know, you have to learn how to breathe properly. That's the key. You play with the E sound, not the R sound, but E, you know, and that like coming through your nose like an opera singing, and you have a great big sound. You can take any mouthpiece and get a big sound and a good sound. If you apply the proper air from your diaphragm and breathe properly, okay. Have a great song. Yeah, I was in San Diego, and at that time I didn't have a wireless. You know, I have a wireless now. You can hear me wherever I perform. I had no wireless, so you could only hear me if I was right in front of you. So we was working in San Diego, and I was marching through the crowd, and when I got outside, I got outside, but my brother couldn't get out because it was so crowded. The off-duty cop saw me blowing my horn downtown, and he called the station and put me in jail. And so I was so long before I got back to the stage. And everybody said, "Where's Big J?" And they said, "Man, cat's in jail." So my brother had to come down and bail me out. It was kind of like, well, I've had many saxophones. This one I'm playing is a Super 8 from Selma, which they gave me. I had a con to him that's in the museum, because like, you know, when I, in my act, and you turn on all the lights, all you see is my saxophone, you know, put on white gloves, so all you see is hands and gloves moving. And different horns have different characteristics of sound, you know, and I like the Selma. I have my keys for raised high, so the sound come out, you know. But if you're playing jazz, you want to close and action real fast because you're playing a lot of movement and a lot of phrases and you can't have your keys up this high, you know. So I have mine out because I want the sound to boom out. Yeah, that's great, you know. I'm 84, you know, but still got the groove and the sound, you know. Young guys try to keep up, you know, but they kind of slow. Really, I be playing with guys, and you know, like I do Deacon Top, that was my first. You know, just kicking, you know, and you know, just keep on going and just keep that fire going. And sometimes they be playing, they trying to keep up, you know. So I don't know whether they don't exercise enough or what, you know.
Today,
oh yeah, I can say something. I love all you guys. It was really great. The performance was great last night, and I love all you people. I'm looking forward to come back. If I'm still alive next year, I hope I'll come back and blow my brains out for you cats.